Hello, I'm Andrew, and today I'm going to clean the Samsung G901DB. The Samsung G901DB is the same receiver as the Samsung G9000. And believe me, guys, this receiver is my best sounding unit I ever had. My best sounding, beautiful sound. And the reason why I'm going to clean it is because, well, I clean all my devices, yes. If I have a device, if I buy a device for myself, I clean it, I review it, yeah. And most of the time I sell it when after the movie, because I'm not a collector, yeah. I am a, well, it is my hobby, yes. Stereo equipment, vintage stereo is my hobby, but I'm not a collector. If I had a lot of money, I was a collector. Believe me, I would not sell most things I reviewed before. I would not sell one of them, maybe a few. I don't like the looks, too many damages on the front side. Those one I would sell, but most of them I had before, I would not sell if I had a lot of money. I don't have a lot of money, and that's the reason why I have to sell this. I sold this thing 4 months ago, yeah. The guy is still waiting for it, and he bought other equipment from me too, some Pioneers, some Akai, and a lot of things, and this is the first thing I will clean for him. So if he sees this movie, probably he will see it, he will like it, because I promised him it will take 2 weeks to clean everything, but as you see, this is my first movie in 4 months, yeah, my cleaning movie. And I will like this thing to clean it, because cleaning is not a punishment. Cleaning a device is a, if you like your device, yeah, probably you have only one device, and you have to keep it clean, yeah, once every, depends if you are a smoker, once every year. If you're not a smoker, you can clean it once in every 5 years. Just take the thing open and clean everything, and the thing will look brand new once you clean it. And I will make 2 movies from this, no, maybe 3, because my first movie is the cleaning movie, my second movie is the review from the Samsung itself. I will do that review in the dark, because in the evening it's more beautiful with the lights from the spots. And now you have the daylight, so, but yeah, it's a cleaning movie, and I need as much as light as possible to clean it. And I make a special setup with, I will use 3 cams. I'm not sure if I will use all images, and I'm gonna show you. This is the device, yes, the Samsung G901DB, and it is dirty. And I have this cam on top of the device, and as you can see, I use my other cam on a tripod. And well, I always use for cleaning, for testing. My first time, this is not the first time I test this thing. This thing sounds beautiful, yeah, but some knobs are dirty. It needs some spray. Yeah, I need to spray it, and I need to clean the knobs. And it is, I'm not sure how long it will take me, but I think it's a job from 2 hours. I don't see this thing, if you have a device like this or not a device, don't see it as a punishment, yeah. Just see it as, well, brushing your teeth, yeah. That thing you do every day, it's important, yeah. And it's also important to keep your device clean. You will have more fun from this device if it is clean, yeah. I'm not a collector, and that's why I sell this thing. And really, probably I will regret it. I regret a few things I sold before, like my Samsung G7000, my Akai A1175, and a few other Marantzes. I regret selling them. But yeah, you know, you cannot keep it all. You can't keep it all. I kept my Luxman 1050, yeah, and a few other ones. And well, it depends what I buy, what I can buy, And if I can buy better stuff, I sold the other stuff, but this thing really was too expensive for me. And I spent so much money on my house, on my interior, that I, well, now I have to. I'm not a rich guy. If I was rich, I wouldn't sell anything. Most of the things I had, I reviewed before. But anyway, this is my movie from, and only the setup took me 30 minutes because I had to take the speakers downstairs. I had to place my tripods with the cams, yeah, and to see if the lighting was okay. And well, let us see what's wrong with this thing. Yeah, I will do the thing on. And there it is. And I use my connection, as you can see, my cable radio. This is my cable antenna, yeah. That's my cable antenna. And I use this thing, and this is how it sounds. And right away you can hear some cracky noise in the volume knob. Listen to this. Let me put some more treble inside it so you can hear it better, the cracking noise. You heard that sound, that cracky noise? Well, that's a dirty volume knob. I have to clean it. I also have a dirty, the treble knob is also dirty. Well, it's Christmas sound, it's Christmas songs, because it's Christmas time. And let me try another station. And this is not a sound test, this is not the review from the sound switch itself. That's why I use these small speakers. The test itself will, I will use some better speakers, some good speakers, so you can hear the sound from this beautiful sounding receiver. But so this is not a sound test. Yeah, the sound test, I will use different speakers. But when I reviewed my stereo room yesterday or 2 days ago, one guy made the remark, because I had these speakers on top, and I said in that movie that I will not review these speakers because I don't think they are worth reviewing them. And then one guy told me, or wrote in my comments, you can read that back in my comment section, that these speakers are not bad at all, that is, they are good speakers. Well, I just test them and I don't like the sound. So sorry guy, the person who wrote that comment, these, if you are happy with these speakers, probably you will be very, very happy with some better speakers, because these speakers, listen to them. Let me put some loudness.
Op weg naar het weekend en op weg naar de nummer 1, maar daar zijn we gelukkig nog lang niet. 1297, daar vinden we Jerry Lee Lewis.
Well, they don't sound bad, but they don't make me happy, you know, these small canoots.
Zo heeft hij een keer zijn bassist neergeschoten, terwijl hij met zijn pistool aan het oefenen was op een blik. Je hoort nu.
But yeah, if you have nothing else. I had speakers sounding much worse than these ones, and those ones were expensive speakers, so they're not that bad at all. But well, I don't think if I place these speakers on the second-hand market, I can get a lot of money for them, so I keep them as test speakers. Yeah, if you have a dirty switch, what happened with my Magnat 05, I blew up one of the woofers because of those dirty switches. Well, it doesn't matter if I blew up one of these speakers. I don't care, yeah. But I will never test again for the first time when I hook up a receiver or an amplifier expensive speakers, because you will cry. Never for the first, but if for the first time hook up your speakers to a new device, you buy it second hand, never use your expensive speakers. First try the thing out on cheap speakers, you can blow up, yeah, like these ones. But okay, I need some dioxide. Yeah, I don't use dioxide. I use this electro contact spray. I'm very happy with the spray Scandia, and I ordered them online before I bought them in a shop close to my house, but the shop doesn't sell them anymore, so I had to go online and I ordered three of these in one time. And well, this is, and as you can see how dirty the knob is, this is all dirt between, dirt. Dirt. You can see here how dirty the thing is. Also behind the glasses is dirt. You can't see it now, but you see it when it is clean. The difference between a dirty unit, a unit what isn't cleaned in 35 years, or a just cleaned device, is the difference is very big always. Well, I have to open the thing and I will show you how to open the thing, yeah. And I have to loosen some screws, as you can see here on the side. Yeah, I will start with these screws, yes. One, two, and the one over here. And I will try to remove the hood, okay? I'm not sure if this receiver was open before, but I guess it was open before. Yeah. So, 35 years. Let's see over here, three of them. So, these are the easy ones. I have to watch my coffee. I just made some coffee. And let me see if I have more. Yeah, probably. I think also here in the back we have a few of these screws. I hope it will be easy to clean it. But I have to loosen the front plate, yeah? Because I want to clean that front plate and behind the front plate too. It was an easy job with my Samsung G7000. Don't think it's a hard job, yeah? Well, you have to be patient, yeah? And never rush these things, never rush these things. And it is, even if you don't know what to do, yeah? Just watch this movie and you will see it, but it's that simple. So, let's see if it is, if I can use the thing already. Yeah, there it comes. There it comes. Well, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to close the thing, take out my electricity, and well, this is how it looks inside. What's this? What's this? Beautiful, beautiful. And I don't think it's very dirty. I don't think I have to do much. Only have to loose all these screws on top. You can see them here. I have to loose them. So I removed three screws on the back side, one on the left, one in the middle, and one on the far right. Yeah. And also the three screws in the wood on the right side and the tree screws on the left side. I also removed the two knobs, the volume knob and the tuning knob, the tuner tuning knob. And as you can see, the only way you can remove these knobs is with a imbus. And I have a complete set like this. It's very important to have this set because, well, most of the time they sell you imbus keys, but they are not complete and you always miss the right key. And I found this, I bought this thing, and I'm so happy because I not only use it for my stereo but also for other things, and I'm very happy with it. And I use the, well, you have the industrial quality, you have the long arm series and the short arm series, and I use the number, as you can see it here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, number 2, yeah, this one I use to open it, number 2, yeah, you can see it here, yeah, these are different sizes, these are inch sizes, and they are different, they are also different in size, yeah. So often you see in those shops, those handy shops, they sell 10 of these keys together, and they are never complete. You always miss one, and this is the complete series. Probably you already have the number 2. This one you need, yeah. And this is how it works. And if you're gonna lose it, you have to spin it. Let me see. You have to spin it anti-clockwise. So you have to return back the clock. That's how you lose the thing. Yeah. So then you have to lose this screw and this screw. Don't remove these two screws. Only this one and this one, so you can take this thing away. Yeah. And then you lose this thing. Yeah. You turn it to the left. I did it with this thing, yes, and then you can remove this thing, yeah, okay, and then you do the same thing, you remove this screw, and that screw, okay. So as you can see, I took out this screw, I took out this screw, and now this is the most tricky part. Yeah, as you can see in the corner, there's another screw, and the only way you can reach that screw is like this. Yes, yeah, I don't know if you can see it. Let me see, well, it's hard to film it, but this is the screw. Yeah, you need, yeah, there it is, there it is, there it is. And this is the way how you have to screw it away. Yeah, and there's one on the left side and one on the right side. And once that's done, you can remove the faceplate. I will try it with one hand. First, remove this thing. Yeah, and then I will try it with one hand. As you can see, first, of course, you take away all the knobs. Yeah, and then the things will come off easy. Well, I think I need two hands for this. Let me see. This is it. It's loosened. It's loosened. And I show you how dirty the thing is. Yeah, the thing is dirty, and even this thing is dirty. It isn't shiny anymore. And normal, this gold, shiny gold. So this is how it is looking inside. And this is all, folks, this is all. And of course I have to
also take away the underside of the receiver to clean the knobs, yeah, the pot meters from the knobs I have to clean, and for that I have to take away the underside, yeah. I already can tell you now that I cannot reach these pots from the upper side. It's the first time I open this thing, so I think I have to place it on its side and to open the side. Well, as you can see, I loosened the back side, and this is how the back is looking. It has three speakerless, you can see them here, three of them, unbelievable. These are the filter caps, four of them on the left side and four of them on the right side. And lucky for me, this is the volume knob, yeah, I can reach it with my spray. And the treble knob is here, I can also just reach it here with my spray. Otherwise, if you want to deoxid or spray all the knobs, yeah, or maybe you have this middle knob, it's hard to reach the middle. The bass is easy to reach from this side, yeah. But you have to, if you want to lose this board, this complete board, yes, you have to loosen this screw. And this screw, and then the board will loosen, and you have all the you can reach all these pot meters, yeah, to clean them. And the same counts for this side, yeah. If one of these switches you have to clean, you have to take away from this board, and to loosen this board, you have to take away this screw, and you have to loosen this screw, and you have to loosen this screw. Then you can take away this board, yeah, to clean the pot meters and the switches, yeah. Probably if only this one needs to be cleaned, or the outside, you can reach them from this side. But if one of these switches are dirty, the only way is to clean them is to take away this board. Let me see if you can reach them from the No, the only way is to take away this board. Lucky for me, only the volume knob is dirty, and I will also clean the balance knob and the treble. Those three. Well, the balance knob was okay, but I will deoxid anyway. And the treble knob was a little bit dirty, and the rest is okay. The rest is okay. Yeah. The outside switch you can reach from there. I don't know if you can see it, but that one you can reach, you can clean. And tone off on, you can also reach from here with your deoxid spray. But the other knobs, these four knobs, you can't reach. Well, maybe the outside with this one and this one, but the middle one will be difficult. You can also clean the bass pot meter from this side, yes. But if you have to clean the mid, then I think you have to take away this complete board. It's the only way. But anyway, I'm going to spray it. Let me put down my cam so you can see what I'm doing. Let's see what I'm doing. Yeah, my spray. I have to, let me first do the treble. The treble is this one. This one is easy. I can reach it from this side here. always use some air duster, pressure air. You can see it here, air duster, yeah. And just to remove the residue, what is left. Oops, that's not okay. Always use some pressure air. Or maybe I can do the mid also. Let me see. I can reach that one easy. Not easy, but I can reach it. Let me see. It will be around here. It will be around here. Just if you don't know how to reach this, you can always bend this thing. Yes, if you can't reach it, okay. You could always and of course I will use again my pressure spray. Just bend it so you can reach it, okay. Yeah, like this. And I will do the bass knob, the volume knob, and this one also I will do when I turn over the complete receiver to the other side, yeah. This is a heavy thing, my friend. This is a heavy thing. So now we have the receiver from this side, and well, I see that I cannot reach the bass. But I can clean the volume knob easy. You can see it right here, the pot meter from the volume knob. Very easy to reach, yeah. Easy to reach that this one over here. Yeah, that's the pot meter from the volume knob. That one is easy to reach. Easy piece of cake. It's never necessary to clean the tuning knob, yeah, because that's not a pot meter. One more time, because the thing was very dirty. Thank you. And then of course, when I finished with the deoxid, I use some pressure air. I don't test it now because I'm almost 100% sure the thing is clean now. And I will also clean the balance knob. This is the balance knob. You can see it right here. Yeah. And it's very easy to access from this side. Yeah. So I will clean. Let me see. No, it's not easy to access. Well, the balance knob wasn't dirty. It wasn't dirty at all. Well, I can access it from this side. I have to return it back again. You know what's a bone back killer? Well, this thing is a backbone killer. Believe me, the thing is heavy. Let me see if I am not making any mistakes. Always use your air pressure spray. It is not necessary. A lot of guys don't use the pressure air, but the thing is cheap. Yeah, I buy this can, complete can, 400 milliliter for about €3. Yeah, we have a cheap shop here, and it's always better to remove the residue, what is left from spraying, to spray that stuff away. Yeah, it's always better. Anyway, it can't harm it. Yeah, so that's why I use this thing always. Yeah, and it's important for me, but probably you will never use it yourself. I don't read often that people use this spray. So I think I'm finished. Well, let me see. Well, I can spray this switch over here. Over here. And I believe That's all I can do. But I think that was all. Most important thing was the volume knob. The volume knob was very scratchy. And that one is clean now. So I can place back my back plate. Okay. Let me see. This is how it was. Easy piece of cake. It's not very hard to do this job. It takes some time. You have to calculate for this job, I think, 1 hour, between 1 and 2 hours. Yeah. If you take 2 hours, then you can't go wrong. Well, let me see. The first one is always the most difficult one. Thank you. So you also take the upper side, yeah, with the tissue, yeah. Just clean it, clean it, clean it. But be careful for the dial pointer. And this is it, folks, this is it. This is all you have to do. And then in the end, I always use my magic brush. And you can say what you want, but there's always some paper left from the tissue, some residue, yeah? And that's why I say this is my magic brush, because this brush already cleaned, I don't know how many receivers, but it cleaned plenty, 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 plenty. Let me clean this one first, this side, yeah. You see the difference? It is unbelievable. It is unbelievable. The thing was beautiful before I start cleaning, and now it is not beautiful. Now it is just incredible. Look at this. Look how the dye pointer is shining now. Well, I think it can use a little extra like this. Say a shiny dial pointer is like the, well, the fruit on the cake, yeah. And but be careful with that dial pointer, yeah. This is a golden, a 24 karat golden dial pointer. You remember how it was? It wasn't shiny at all. And I will be back when I place back all the knobs. You see, all these ones are shining also now. Yes, the switches. Also, these switches are shiny, and these ones. So I'm going to clean the knobs. They are already in the water, and I'm going to clean them, place back the front side and the knobs, and I will be back when the thing is completely finished, okay? Oh, look at this, unbelievable. This is a real beauty. This is a real beauty. And well, what's this? And I don't have good light here, so I cannot show you how beautiful it is. But well, you will get the review. You will get the review, and you will see it in good spotlight when I'm going to film it in my stereo room, because the review I will do in my stereo room. And as you can see, how beautiful the thing is shining. Unbelievable, what a difference, what a difference. The thing is brand, brand new. And let me see, put some sound. Let me see, speaker on. Okay, listen to this. Okay, remember, it is still on the small, as you can see, these small Kenwood speakers, yeah, so don't expect a super sound, but you will hear how it sounds on my Magnat speakers when I will test them upstairs in the stereo room. And this is how it sounds now over these Kenwoods.
Zerbombte Städte, Flüchtlinge vor Stacheldrahtzäunen, entwurzelte Menschen, Hunger. Eindrücke kriegen. Anfang des Werbefotograf in Zürich. Seinem Vater schrieb Bischof 1908:
This is it. Okay, thanks for watching this movie. And if you like it, put your thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe on my channel. For now, I say bye-bye.